Hey guys, Brian here. Thank you to Nissan for sponsoring this video. I hope you guys enjoy it.
Oh, what's up, bro? How you been?
I'm good, doc.
All right.
Yo, man, did you do the homework?
Nah, we had homework?
You would have known if you used Notion like I told you.
Bro, that app's whack, bro. I'm good, man.
Yeah, man, if you say so.
All right, I'll catch you later.
All right, doc.
Oh, shit.
I'm so glad I checked my Notion.
Hey guys, welcome to the video. Today I'm going to be showing you guys my Notion setup for the school year and also how I use Notion in my everyday life. For those of you guys that don't know what Notion is this excellent tool that a lot of students use. It's basically an app where you guys can customize your schedules for school, make to-do lists, reading lists, and have a whole bunch of other things integrated in one workstation. I think I've been using Notion for about a year now. Honestly, I love the app a lot because before I'd have to use different apps to just get what I wanted. So I'd go to Google Calendar for my calendar, Todoist for my to-do list, and then a note-taking app for my notes. But now with Notion, you can literally integrate all those apps into one home station, one dashboard. And that's what's been helpful as I go through college. And honestly, I think Notion is pretty simple and easy to use if you don't try hard on your dashboard, but there's a lot of free templates that you guys can use on Notion. Templates for school, career stuff, personal habits in your life. The cool part about just customizing your own dashboard or homepage is that you can create it in your own unique aesthetic, as you guys will see with mine in this video. You can also use the dashboard or your Notion in general to collaborate with your friends so you can invite multiple people to work on one page. With that being said, let me take you guys through my Notion setup and also show you guys how this app could change your life for the better.
Okay guys, welcome to my Notion dashboard. This is basically where I store my whole entire life. As you can see, there's a lot going on here, but I want to break it down for you guys so it's simple. So first, we just have my name and quote of the year. I always have a quote of the year so I can just open up my dashboard. The first thing I see, just to remind myself of what I need to accomplish. Most of these things are embedded, so I use like this external website called Indify, I think, where I got to embed like a clock and then a Pomodoro timer, which is essentially like a timer you take when you want to do some homework or grind for a bit. So I would start the timer for like 25 minutes, let that go on for a bit, and then usually pause it and then go on, take a 5 minute break and then get back to work. And you can like edit the length of the duration the timer goes on for, but it's a pretty nice widget to have. Next, we got my weather app here and just like a tracker for goals throughout the year. Going down, we have my academics. So I sort things by pages in here. I have my school website embedded, so I can just click on that to go into log into my Blackboard and stuff like that. So it's pretty helpful. Then Notion lets you actually embed Spotify playlists. So I always have my Spotify playlist I use for studying. It's just a lot of lo-fi coffee shop music usually, but it's really helpful when I go through different homework and have to study for my exams. Next, we have a habit section where I just have my gym routine here listed. You can actually make a gallery view and just have everything here. So I usually have that for the gym, book list for me to read. As I said earlier, you can have a book list. And then my head hurts is just where I put my random thoughts of the day. Like today is just reviewing resumes for my friends, but that's what I had to do. And then I have my skincare. So just check that for a reminder every day. And then I'm doing a 10K this year. So I have a training program here that I just open the page and check out. But in addition to that, on my dashboard, I have a seasonal watch list where I just track like anime I'm watching or shows. So right now, these are the anime I'm watching at the moment. So comment down below if you guys are watching any of these as well. And then I have like the episode counter as well. The cool thing about Notion is that you get to integrate other software. So I have a to-do list here that is an integration. So essentially, whenever I have something done, like this has been done already, I can just cross it off my to-do list and then continue on and add multiple agendas going up forward in the day. I also have my Google Calendar linked to Notion as well, so I have that embedded with Indify, so I can see like things I have to do, like class tomorrow and stuff like that. It's pretty helpful, and that's just the general dashboard at the moment. But next, let's go into our college section. Okay, so this is a page that's going to be most relevant for college students or students in general. This is my college dashboard, essentially. So I have a master task board, which is really cool. So if I click on this, there's these things in Notion called databases where you can just sort a wide variety of different information and filter by different things. So here I have the assignments listed out for my classes. Then I have my class where I had like different tags I made for each class to categorize all the information. Super helpful. And you can also input due dates with the calendar if you insert it. So you can choose like the specific due date, which is really helpful. And then I have a status where I just show things that are in progress, not started, done. Another cool thing you can do is also change like the type. So instead of doing the status, I could actually just do a checkbox instead, if that's easier, and you can just mark it as check. But I like status just because it has like more color there. The really cool part about Notion is that you can insert formulas, which is basically like programming a code. Shout out to my friend OE. This may look really intimidating, but it's essentially a countdown timer and allows us to, based on the assignment due date, just indicate if things have been past due, things that are due the day. So luckily I did all my homework that I had for this week, and then things that are due in the future. So you see the countdown says 4 days remaining. I also think if it's the next day, I have a code here where it also says like, oh, due tomorrow, if it's within 24 hours, and it'll tell me that. But super cool, really cool way to use databases in Notion. Next, if you go to my task board for like one of my random classes here, you can actually, the cool thing about Notion is you can link your database to another page. So this is essentially the same task I had in the master task board, but I filtered it by classes to make it easier for myself to just see like all the different classes separately from one another. Super helpful as well, but you don't have to do this. This is just like a little bit extra. Another cool part is notes. So one really cool thing is how you can make a database for actually notes. So I have all my notes listed out here. I barely took any for this class, but you can create a side view of the page, or you can switch the view to like a full page, which is super cool. Another thing you can do is also insert drop-down layers. So I have like pictures of like things I had for my quiz, the review as well. So it's super helpful in that regard. Additionally, with notes, if you didn't want to do it like that, you could literally just make a new page in Notion. And the cool thing about Notion is there's like a ton of templates. So I could choose a template, go here, click on class notes, have all my class notes there. So I could choose this template if it looks cool. There's a whole wide variety of different templates that you guys can choose, but I personally like to make things myself just because it's more simple and I think it's like less intimidating. Another cool thing I have is like an expense tracker where I just put like the textbooks I bought throughout the semester or anything related to college, and I'll just insert the receipt here and have like where it's from, how much it was, and what bank account I used for it. But super helpful. Okay, so back to my main homepage. I want to show you guys one real cool thing. So I made a page for YouTube where I basically just have a content calendar. So I don't have that much filled out for this month, but if you look at last month, essentially you can see dates that I have things. So this is when like I posted a vlog. If I want to film or write a storyboard for a video, I'll just write it here. So like this is one for like the Notion video I have, and I'll show you all that in a bit. But it's really cool because the Notion calendar, you literally can just type in anything like brush teeth, right? And then you can like insert a cover, and you can literally choose anything or just like upload an image, which is really cool. Makes things really cool. And you just take your notes. Like if you have something to do, you can write down your scripts and stuff like that. So really helpful. This is like really like basic, but I basically have like a video planner with Notion, which is just a bunch of pages and like one thing. So this is like a bunch of videos I have planned for you guys, but I'm blurring this out so y'all can't see this. You can literally just organize your Notion however you want it. This is kind of messy, but that's just how I like it because I'm pretty simple. Overall, this is my dashboard on Notion. It's kind of a little intimidating, but I thought it was pretty simple. It took me a few hours to make though, but I'm always upgrading my Notion. And one cool thing I have here is like a college archive where I just have like all my old pages and stuff where I just put that in there to make it easier. You guys can organize your Notion however you want. And the cool thing is there's just so many templates. Like I showed you all earlier, there's so many things you can do. So I would honestly just get Notion and experiment with the different features that it has to offer.
Anyways, if you guys are a college student or student in general, I'd highly recommend trying out Notion. It'll make your life so much easier. But if you guys do want to try it out, you can check out my link down below in the description. And if you guys like the template I showed in the video, comment down below if you want me to make my dashboard public for y'all to use. But I need to do some homework, so as always, I'll see y'all in the next one. So, peace.
Oh my god, it's so awkward.